Welcome to this video. In this video, we will study what is an atom. Have you ever seen an anthill? What is the constructive unit of an anthill? Correct. It is a small particle of sand. In the same way, have you ever thought about what is the constructive unit of all substances? The constructive unit of all substances is an atom. Have you ever seen an atom? No. But why? Because they are so small, we cannot imagine or even compare. The atomic radius is measured in nanometers. When millions of atoms are placed on top of them, as a single rock, a layer as thick as a sheet of paper will be able to form. Now you must be thinking, when atoms are so small that we can consider the subtlety of their size negligible, then why should we study about it? We should study this because our whole world is made up of atoms, and these atoms affect each of our activities. Let us first see what the atoms of different elements symbolize. Dalton was the first scientist who used the symbols of the elements in a very specific sense. Berzelius suggested that the symbols of elements be made from one or two letters of the name of the element. Initially, the names of the elements were derived from the names of the places where they were found to be first. For example, the name copper was derived from Cyprus, and some elements were named after specific colors. For example, gold was derived from an English word that means yellow. In the modern period, the International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry, IUPAC, approves the names of the elements. Symbols of most elements are made up of one or two letters of the English names of those elements. The first letter of a symbol is always written in capital and the second letter in small. For example, for hydrogen, H. For aluminium, Al. For cobalt, Co, etc. Similarly, the symbols of some elements are made by combining the first alphabet of their English names and any one alphabet that comes later, such as for chlorine, Cl, for zinc, Zn, etc. There are also some elements whose symbols are derived from their names in Latin, German, or Greek languages. For example, iron symbolizes Fe, which is derived from its Latin name, ferrum. Similarly, sodium symbol is Na and potassium symbol is K. They are derived from natrium and calcium. Thus, each element has a name and a unique chemical symbol. Let us now discuss atomic mass. According to Dalton, each element has a characteristic atomic mass. Inspired by Dalton's theory, scientists were prompted to measure the atomic mass of an atom. Relative atomic masses were determined using the laws of chemical combinations and the compounds formed. Let us try to understand it by an example. Carbon monoxide, CO, is made up of carbon and oxygen. It is made by combining 3 grams of carbon and 4 grams of oxygen. In other words, we can say that carbon combined with 4 by 3 times its mass of oxygen. Now, if we consider atomic mass unit to be equal to 1 carbon atomic mass, then we will assign carbon atomic mass to 1.0 U and oxygen atomic mass to 1.33 U, where U is the unified mass. But because it is more convenient to express mass in integers or nearly integers, later scientists researched different atomic mass units. During this time, they took 1/16th part of the atomic mass of natural oxygen as a unit. This is deemed to be relevant because 1. Oxygen reacts with many elements to form compounds. 2. Atomic mass of most elements are obtained in integers by this atomic mass unit. However, in 1961, the atomic mass unit carbon-12 isotope was universally accepted as a standard reference for determining atomic masses. Let us understand this by a daily life example. Imagine a salesman carrying a watermelon and saying, "Its mass is 12 units." He then slices 12 equal pieces of watermelon and finds that the mass of each fruit itself is relative to a piece of watermelon. Now he sells fruits by a relative fruit mass unit, FMU. Just like in this example, the relative atomic mass of atoms of an element is defined as the average mass of atoms as compared to 1/12th part of the mass of one carbon-12 atom. Friends, in this video, we studied atomic mass. In the next video, we will learn what is a molecule.